last day that kill buck.
Can't hurt.
Yeah, I told you, Stu.
What is it?
It's a buck! Good.
DeerHunterFan.com TV is sponsored by 12 Point Property Management, Bee Stinger, Gold Tip, Insane Archery, Longhorn Fab Shop, Ohio Trophy Buck Outfitters, Vapor Trail, and also by these fine sponsors.
Hi, I'm Brian Madison with DeerHunterFan.com TV. This week we're going to have a look at our hunt with Ohio Trophy Buck Outfitters during the week of October 28th. We got there on a Monday, midday, so we were able to hunt Monday evening. And the first night in, I went into an area, this property, we had it all to ourselves, and it was thick bedding in a bottom, a lot of goldenrod and berry briars, surrounded just kind of by pasture and old hay fields. So no destination food sources. So we knew that, you know, we'd be hunting deer most likely late morning is when they'd be funneling back in. And in the afternoons, we'd have to try to sneak in there without pushing any deer out. All right, well, we're back in the truck. I'll tell you what, that was a good first set here with Ohio Trophy Buck Outfitters. We've been put on a property all to our own, and it looks like a great property. Saw a lot of deer. Like I said, I didn't even have the tree arm on the tree yet, and I had deer walking by. One up spooking a couple does, and two weren't too scared and walked off. I saw 12 doe all together. I think that at least four of them, though, were the same deer. It looks like we're in a very heavy bedding area, and I think that those doe were just kind of browsing around, and like I said, some of them were the same ones. I found that shed on my way in a bed.
if that buck's still hanging around there, he's gonna be a great buck this year. So like I said, we're hoping to see some bucks in the morning. I would not be surprised if this spot we were just in is actually better in the morning. So we're already planning on trying to sit till at least 11 o'clock, because where we're at, there are no destination food sources. It's all pasture, and then this bottom that's just thick goldenrod and bedding area. So I think the deer will be funneling back into our area throughout the morning. And I mean, even this morning, the deer were still out feeding in fields at 11 o'clock in the morning. We saw them. So the deer are definitely on the move. Weather's, temperature's cool. It's nice out. I think these deer are going to get a nice relief from the weeks that were warm before this. And hopefully the bucks are on their feet. Today, when we first drove into this property, we saw a little basket rack 8-point and a little tiny buck with them. So the deer are definitely moving. I don't think we disturbed it too bad getting in and out of there for our first time. The terrain was pretty rough, so I know that we each made some noise getting in, but obviously, like I said, we had deer coming in pretty much instantly, so we're excited for the morning.
So the next morning went just the plan. Got in there nice and quiet and didn't bump any deer, and shortly after it started to get light, saw deer crossing the hilltops and coming back into this bottom. Thank you.
those two young bucks were just actually look like they're fighting. I'm not gonna call that sparring. They got into it pretty good. I could actually hear their antlers. And I just did a little bit of rattling. They keep looking down the woods over here, so I'm assuming those two bigger bucks are pushing those does around this bottom over here. Just gotta hope they come up here. Thank you.
after the hunt and seeing these nice bucks coming out further down the field, I got down, went and found a tree there in a very nice crossing. There was no berry briars, just some nice goldenrod, kind of mowed down where the deer, no doubt, crossed there more than any other place. And went in there, found one climbable tree, left my climber off, and went out a different direction up to a well. And in the evening, I walked right back down that well road and then down a little deer trail across the creek. Got in there nice and quiet. It was a quiet, crispy afternoon, so the squirrels were making some noise for cover. And turns out that was a good thing.
Okay, I'm all set tonight. I actually moved down this ridge line probably 200 yards right to where those bucks came out this morning. It's a little bit of an aggressive move, but I feel as though it could pay off. And actually, now that I'm in the stand, I can't actually shoot into the field. It's a 40-yard shot, the fence line. So I really like that a lot. And if those bucks are moving like they were this morning, or if tomorrow morning if they are, and I'm able to get in here without bumping anything like it was tonight, nice and quiet, I think we have a good chance of running into one of them. So we'll see what happens.
After sitting there the whole afternoon, got to be 6 o'clock, and 35 yards away, a deer stands up out of the goldenrod. So after a while of him beating up this tree, when he stopped, I finally grunted and got his attention, and he turned and started coming my way. I knew the shot was back on this deer, a little lower than I would have liked. So I knew right away I was backing out. Got down nice and quiet, went over just far enough to grab my arrow, and then actually took the long way out of this ravine. Punishing way to get out of there, because he ran in the direction that I would head out to go to the road, so I couldn't go that way. And then it was just a long wait overnight. Wednesday, October 30th, it's the next morning. Last night, decided to back out just because it looked like the buck was slightly quartering in. Shot was just a little lower than I would have liked. We're here. Last night, had excellent blood on the arrow. Did not track that blood trail one step. So this is it. We're going in this morning. Hopefully, I was able to get out there quiet enough that if it was a marginal hit, he didn't go far. Got Travis helping. We're gonna hopefully go get this buck.
Dude, he's right there! Oh my god. He's right there. Oh my lord. Oh my god. Oh baby! Look at this buck. Coyotes can have his tail. This thing is he ran 100 yards. Yes.
Less than that.
Look at this buck. I can't believe it. I need a hug. I need a hug from my camera. Yeah. Yes, dude. Oh, man.
Dude.
Yes.
Just going to take 5 minutes here and send out a lot of texts and pictures, because last night was a sleepless night, and I spent all night harassing all my buddies, asking what they thought about the shot. And they're all reassured me, Brian, that buck didn't run more than 100 yards, and they were all right. I'm gonna send out some texts. This is a monster. All right, so here we are. We got him this morning. He only ran 100 yards, but it's a very good thing we backed out. Shot was back like we thought. This is a great buck. So excited. You wanna talk about a tough arrow. This arrow this season, this gold tip arrow, has gone through a coyote, a buck, missed a doe, and just went through one of the biggest bucks I've ever shot. So. Man, have to give a lot of thanks to that bee stinger. Everything worked awesome. Vapor trail arrow rust. I've just been shooting so good this year. I rushed this shot, and that's why I missed it just a little bit. But we backed out. You'll learn from mistakes in the past. Back out.
come in the next morning, you get your deer, they usually don't go far.
All right, so we got him back to the lodge here. One little side note I forgot to mention earlier was the first day in, I was able to find this buck's shed. And that's really cool. It was only just about 200 yards from where I wound up taking him. And like I said, the story, the way it unfolded, it was nerve-wracking. But we got him, and we made the right choice by backing out last night. Ty was there to help us this morning and get him back here. And actually, another hunter in camp had luck. Took a very nice buck. We'll show you that rack in just a second. But it's a great place here. Ohio Trophy Buck Outfitters. Check out the website. It's on the screen there. And there's a reason we keep coming back here year after year.
Chris Satansky from Marlboro, New York. Shot this 8 last night, about 3:30 in the afternoon, actually. And came out about 70 yards. Took a turn. Came right to me. Put a shot on him about 30 yards away. And team tag out gets it done again.
You know, this buck, the story just keeps to grow on this buck. For the little bit of history I did have with him by finding his shed on the way in the first night, and you can definitely tell it was his shed. He had the started little sticker down by the base of his antler, had the fat bases, had the split brow tine, and then the started crab claw up where he grew his G4 on that side.
And I wound up naming this buck Quattro because of his four brow tines.
But after taking this buck to the taxidermist, they looked at the cape, and first of all, he had a number of wounds. Looked like puncture wounds from getting in a fight and getting pinned down right on the top of his back. You could actually see it in the video. And then one right in his side in his rib cage. It was infected very bad. I don't know how long this deer would have lived, to be honest with you, if he couldn't fight off that infection. But other than that, the taxidermist pulled out a slug out of this buck's neck. Looked like it had either gone in here and just lodged up over here. So I don't know what the story behind that was, but it's pretty neat to have that slug, and shows you what a tough buck this buck was. Originally we were thinking he might have been 3 years old based on the shed we found. We will look into that a little more later, but you know, a buck like that around here you'd think would be older, but definitely down there in Ohio, Central Ohio, with all the farmland, bucks get really big real fast. So we're thinking he was a three-year-old, and I wouldn't be surprised if the story grows a little more on this buck, and if it does, I'll tell you in coming weeks. But that's going to do it for this week on DeerHunterFan.com TV. We'll see you next time.
DeerHunterFan.com TV is sponsored by 12 Point Property Management, Vapor Trail, Bee Stinger, Insane Archery, Gold Tip, Longhorn Fab Shop, Ohio Trophy Buck Outfitters, and also by these fine sponsors, and DeerHunterFan.com, an original online free hunting show.